form an interview that I was just walking down the street. So absorbing that extraordinary environment. And then picking up various materials. I began to put them into the pages of a sketchbook that I had. And I just began to do over and over, every night. And so those sketchbooks began to emerge as an experience, as a kind of document. And then I left them alone for many years. And then I began to explore the Tulip as a form. And it was a form that had physicality. A form that no longer was simply a flower. But what I had expected was the physicality of the flower and of its relationship to space, how it was taking space. And I analogized that to the way in which African Americans took space, the way they stand, the way they the way they're shaped in the moment. And so that flower became a kind of gift. It could describe a state of being, and therefore it is the state of being that, for me, Africans, in a new context, like Tulip, taken out of its original environment, transformed through a series of manipulations and movements through the course of time, it took on different shapes from manipulation. And so I began to play with it in that way. And so it took on meaning metaphysically because of the way it functioned. For example, the stem as a kind of center post, and its petals as a kind of a dressing, almost like a lotus, the four corners of the universe. It opens to the sunlight, and it closes. So it has a kind of built-in duality. That is, it is this and that simultaneously. It functions in extraordinarily or harsh situations. And even in this argument, and so if you get a view in words, yeah.